All right, if you don't mind me saying that, if you can tell us, like, things that happened here.
Well, there are three ghosts that we know of, three spirits we know of that hang around here, that we know for a fact hang around here. There's about five of them altogether, I think, but there's three of them we know. One is a guy named Ray Flowers. He died. He came to Oakman in about 1908. He came from Ireland. He was trying to get enough money to get his family back over from Ireland and get them into the United States. He got enough money to get them on a ship, but then the ship sank. Now, we assume because of the time frame, his family was probably on the Titanic. But we don't know that for sure. It's just a rough estimate because we know the time frame was on. Well, shortly after he lost his entire family in the shipwreck, he started drinking. And about 2 years after his family died, he was drinking so much one night that he walked out the back side of this place, and there's a bridge that goes across to the mountain behind us. He was so drunk that he fell off and broke his neck, or fell onto something and killed himself. And so ever since then, the four or five people I know that have actually seen him, he'll actually appear to them, like they're standing right in front of him.
Oh, wow.
And he'll tell them the same thing. He tells everybody the same thing, and that's, until they bury me proper, I'll continue to haunt the Oakman Hotel. Now, nobody from that area is around. Nobody knows exactly what happened. We just assume that the story was that they didn't find him for like 3 days after he fell in the first place. So that when they did find him, you know, he was kind of a pauper and didn't have a lot of money on him or something. So instead of taking him down to the graveyard or someplace and burying him with a service and everything, they just stuck him in a hole in the ground and covered him up. And they're not too happy about it.
Oh, wow.
And that's the story about him. There's another lady that lives up in the hotel. Her name was Sarah. And the best we know is she came to town around 1920. She was in town somewhere around the 1920s. I don't know exactly what year, but somewhere along there. And somewhere along the line, her husband or her lover or whatever he was, told her, I had to go leave town to take care of some business. Says, don't leave, I'll be back for you. Just stay right here for me, wait for me. Well, he left. Never came back. There was never even word from him again. Nobody knows what happened to him or where he went. And eventually she became a school teacher up here at the schoolhouse up on the hill. And she worked there until she was older. And once she was older, she retired, and she was living up in one of his rooms upstairs. And she literally passed away in the room up there in the corner. Well, the few people that I know of that have actually seen her, they refer to her as sitting in a rocking chair, looking like her hair's really tight back, like she's, you know, kind of an older, you know, tight, you know, the old type.
Yeah.
And she basically tells them that, you know, she's waiting for her husband, her boyfriend, to come back and pick her up. And she's still waiting there, as far as we know. I myself have personally witnessed the rocking chair sounds up in the room, because I've been here since 1990. And when I first got here, I spent a lot of nights up in this hotel because I knew the owner real well. And anytime him and his wife would leave town, they'd have me sit in the place as a bodyguard or to rent the rooms out. So I've been in this hotel upstairs and spent many, many nights here. And there are nights you get up when you know there's nobody in the place, and you will hear footsteps walking up and down the hallway. You will hear a rocking chair rocking back and forth in that one room or in that area and stuff. And there was all kinds of things you would hear up in this place at night, you know, or even during the day if it's quiet enough up there, you would hear. The other guy that we know of for a fact is here is a guy named John. Now, John actually had nothing to do with the hotel. He had to do with the restaurant before it became a restaurant in the 80s. Was actually it had been an assay office. It had been a small mechanic shop. It had been gone through a lot of different, you know, life frames as far as business and things it was used for. And it wasn't made into a restaurant until the late 1980s. Well, there's a guy that likes to sit down here at this table right at the bottom of these stairs. His name is John, and from the best we know, he was one of the employees or one of the owners of one of the shops that was there. Now, whether he died in the shop or whether he just, you know, it was his business, so he was attached to it so well that he just stayed, nobody knows.
But, oh, wow.
But we do. I've had some people who have actually sit down and carry on a conversation with
them. Oh, okay.
My mother's.
Wow, thank you. But, do you mind giving us your name real quick? Or?
Michael. Michael Fox.
Oh, okay, thank you.
But it's not just the hotel. The whole town's got hauntings of it all over the place. There's several haunted houses up on top of the hill. There's at night, there are places that there are people that will pick up, spirit. They just feel stuff, and you'll feel stuff. And at night, I used to do a ghost tour here for about a year and a half. And the guy would bring people up from Laughlin, and then when he got him here, he lived with me for an hour, and I'd drag him up down the town, telling him what I saw, what I knew, had been told about certain places, and what I'd seen myself. And I used to tell him every time that I'm up here, I said, your odds of actually having something supernatural or weird happen is probably about 20%. Okay?
Oh, wow.
Your average of experiencing something you can't explain is probably about 50%. But your odds of catching something in a photograph you cannot explain later down the line are about 80% of it.
Really?
When I used to come in here, he would bring them up usually 2-3 times a week. And we did that for a year and a half. And I don't remember more than once or twice where they brought them up that we didn't get some kind of picture that had something in it that was odd and that you just simply couldn't explain. And we actually had two photographs through that year and a half where the people that took the picture actually had full body apparitions in the photographs. So
you guys still have
a lot of things going on.
Would you still have them?
Whoever took them, I've saw them.
Oh, okay.
I don't know who had them, or they didn't send me a copy of it. So as far as I know, I don't.
Now, what was the possibility if we can get an investigation tonight? Would that be?
Yeah, you'd have to talk to Sean or Teresa or Susie.
Okay, yeah, I talked to Susie before, but they said she's not here today, so.
So Sean and Teresa would be the ones you'd have to deal with.
Okay.
Well, I don't own the place. I only play music here, and that's it.
Okay, well, thank you very much. I really appreciate your time. Hey, thank you.